الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله صلى الله تعالى عليك وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته to everyone. Alhamdulillah, once again, I welcome you all to this another episode on how to spend Ramadan Mubarak. Alhamdulillah, it is with the tawfiq what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to me. I'm here, inshallah al-azim, to cover another topic to increase our knowledge to and get a little bit more understanding in regards to zakah. Alhamdulillah, in last episode, we covered some of the topics in regards to zakah that was to do with the what zakah is and what is the meaning of word zakat. And likewise, we discussed the threshold or the nisab and the wisdom behind why zakat was made obligatory. Inshallah, in today's session, we are going to cover the topic to whom zakat should be given. Because this is obligatory charity and there is guidelines or there is ayat which gives us clear information that if we are taking our zakat out or if this charity needs to be given, then who are those people on whom we can spend this zakat? So in Surah Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْعَامِلِينَ عَلَيْهَا وَالْمُؤَلِّفَةِ الْقُلُوبُهُمْ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ وَالْغَارِمِينَ وَفِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ فَرِيدَةً مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ, the obligatory charity, what we take out, zakah, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ, that it's only for those who are poor, and masakin, the really needy, وَالْعَامِلِينَ عَلَيْهَا, and those who collect it, وَالْمُعَلَّفَةِ الْقُلُوبُهُمْ, and for those in whose hearts the love of Islam needs to be instilled, وَفِي الرِّقَابِ, and to free slaves, وَالْغَارِمِينَ, and to the debtors or one who is in debt, وَفِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, and in Allah's cause, in Allah's way, وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ, and to the travelers. فَرِيدَةً مِّنَ اللَّهِ, this is ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knowing, wise. So, alhamdulillah, this is the ruling, or this is the ayat of Quran which gives us clear guidelines. There's clear mention on where zakat needs to be spent. And that's the reason we need to be careful when it comes to giving zakat, that it needs to be, your zakat is only going to be, or you will be relieved of responsibility of taking your zakat out if it's given to the right people whom Sharia qualifies or Sharia says they are eligible, or these are the category of people on whom zakat can be spent. So the very first category which is mentioned in the ayat is lil fuqara. Now, as soon as we hear the word faqir, we think these are people whom we see begging, on streets or begging anywhere. But shari faqir, or in Sharia, when they say faqir, what does that mean? So our ulama, they say the poor person or faqir is one who has some possessions but not enough money to reach the qualifying threshold or nisab. Nor does he have enough goods in his house to reach the level of nisab. So maybe he has some possessions, maybe he has house, but he doesn't have enough money. Okay, so he's just surviving. He doesn't have anything extra to have the threshold or nisab which is fixed by Sharia. So zakat can be given to that person. And again, ulama, they mention that if such a person is a scholar, a alim-e-deen, then it is better to give it to him. Because as we know, alhamdulillah, ulama and scholars, they dedicate their life for the spread of Islam, for strengthening the Islam. And if we see any such alim al-deen who comes into this category of, faqir, sharif faqir, and if you can help him, then it's always good to give someone who has dedicated himself for deen. So inshallah, you'll be helping to good cause, or you will be helping someone who is working towards strengthening deen. The second category which is mentioned here is miskeen. Now, miskeen is a person who has nothing. So he's a poor person who doesn't have anything. And Sharia says such a person is allowed to beg, but a poor person is not, because a poor person has some possessions, even though it is not enough to reach the level of nisab. So as we said, faqir, he is not allowed to beg, but someone who is miskeen or needy, he is allowed to beg. And the reason poor person or faqir is not allowed to beg, because even though he doesn't have enough, but he has some possessions, but he doesn't have enough wealth to reach to the threshold on nisab fixed by Sharia. And again, our ulama, they mention, if a person has enough to eat for even one day, it is permissible, it is not permissible for him to beg. So if someone has even got something to eat for a day, then it is not right for that person, it is not permissible for person, it is not allowed for that person to beg. So especially those people who go around asking or begging money, and if they say that they are Muslim, then they need to be careful. And if you know of anyone that who is in such a situation, and if he's a Muslim, then you need to make him aware of this masala, that if he has got something to eat, then he shouldn't be begging around. And this is something which is disliked in Sharia. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one of the hadith has mentioned the explanation of the mafhum of that hadith is, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, if any person opens the door of begging, then there'll be other doors, you know, of dependency which will open on that person. He will be always, and this is what we have seen, anyone who unnecessarily puts his hand in front of someone, then we see that person living his life like that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. In fact, there is dua of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in which Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he seeks the protection and refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from being in such a situation. So we need to be careful, we should make dua. But this is one of the categories where you can spend or you can give your zakat to someone who is miskeen, someone who is needy. They can be helped with the obligatory charity, what you will be taking out from your wealth. The another is called collector or amil. Now, amil is a person, collector can be given zakat even if he's a rich, and amil is that person who is appointed by the leader of Muslims to collect zakat. Okay, so if you see anyone who is amil and he is appointed to take zakat, then he can be given zakat. There are two more categories which are mentioned here. You know, it was in early stages of Islam. If there were people, to get them close to Islam, alhamdulillah, in them days, they knew if someone is inclined towards Islam, it was allowed to give zakat to them so that they can get they can be encouraged to follow Islam. But it's been said, our ulama, they say now this doesn't apply. So that's the reason I'm not going to talk, even for a little bit detail, because it doesn't apply. Likewise, freeing slave. So even this is one of the ways how someone can spend their zakat money. I don't know whether it still exists, but if it happens, if you've seen anyone who is a slave, although slavery doesn't exist, but if you see any Muslim as a slave, you can use this money to free that, use your zakat to free that person. The third category, which is mentioned in Sharia, is called gharim. Gharim is person who is in debt. So someone who is qarzdar, someone who has borrowed money. So you are allowed to give zakat to that person. But what should be the level of debt? So our ulama, they mention, they say gharim is the person, and it's on this condition you can give him zakat, that if the amount of zakat is deducted from whatever he owns, he doesn't have anything left that can reach or that can take him to the threshold or nisab. So that person will be eligible to take zakat. Okay. So if you see any such person, sometimes, people, they are living life and they don't like to mention it to anyone. But if you see anyone who is in debt and he is in need of zakat money, and his debt is so much that, even if he has some assets with him, it's less than what debt he has, then you can use your zakat money to help such person. And remember one thing, sometimes we think it's more rewardable to help someone who is miskeen, someone who is in need, but I came across hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which has been mentioned there's more reward to help someone with money. If someone has, wants to borrow money from you, then it's better to help him than giving any miskeen or giving someone to beg money. And our ulama, they say, because someone who is begging or someone who is coming around to take money, you're not 100% sure whether this person really needs. But someone who comes asking for debt, then majority of the cases, but if someone has got this habit, then that's a different thing. But it's only someone who has intention of returning it, and someone who is in need, he comes to take or he comes to borrow money from someone. So if you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with wealth, and if you think you can help someone with that, then helping someone with money to establish that person or to help him in a situation where he's financially in need, then is a good thing to do. And another beautiful thing which is mentioned in the hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, that if someone borrowed money from you, and because of his financial situation, if he is not able to return you money, okay, so there was time fixed saying you need to return money at so and so date, so and so time, and if he is not able to return that money because of some genuine reasons, and if you give extension to that person, if you extend the time for him to repay his debt, then our ulama mentioned that every day which is given as extension, for example, if you have given maybe 100,000, 1 lakh rupees as a debt to someone, and now it was said that you need to return this money on 31st of May. Now on 31st of May, that person comes and says that I don't have that money. I'm not in a state to return that money. And if you extend the time for that person, if you give him some extra time, inshallah, the extension what you give for every day which is given as extension, you will be getting sawab of giving 100,000 or 1 lakh rupee as sadaqah in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So literally speaking, it's not something possible to give you or to do every day. But alhamdulillah, if you help anyone with the situation which is mentioned, inshallah, for every day what extension what you grant him, inshallah, you will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you're giving sadaqah, as if you're giving charity in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the amount what you have helped that person with. So even this is one of the categories, or even this is one type of one category or type of people on whom you can spend your zakat money. And the next is in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or fi sabilillah. This means to spend in the path of Allah. There are many ways that this can be done. And some of the things what we can see in a real life scenario is, it can be given to haji, or someone who was on hajj and who has been robbed of his money along the way. Someone went for hajj and he was robbed, and now he's not left with anything, and he doesn't have any access to his funds. So in situation like this, you can use your zakat to help that person. A student studying religion or deen can also be given zakat. So if there are, alhamdulillah, students who have dedicated themselves for learning Islam, for learning deen, so even they can be helped with zakat money. And alhamdulillah, we see There are many, many youngsters, many youth, alhamdulillah, they dedicate their life for deen, alhamdulillah. They give their life to become hafiz, they give their life or they spend their time becoming alim-e-deen. So alhamdulillah, this is one of the places where you can use your zakat to help such students who have dedicated themselves for learning the knowledge of Islam. And the last category which is mentioned here is traveler or musafir. Now this means musafir who is a shari'i musafir or musafir as per sharia. This means the traveler who has run out of supplies or money, even if he has wealth at his home, it is allowed for such a person to collect zakat. So someone was traveling and whilst traveling, he lost whatever he had. Now he is stranded. Now although he might be millionaire back home, now it's a bit difficult to think someone in this situation in today's day and time, but it might happen that he's stranded. He doesn't have any access to the money what he has. So although he might be millionaire, he might be quite well off at his home, but whilst he's traveling, when everything is robbed and he's stranded, such a person can accept zakat. And if you want to give, you can help such a person with zakat if you want to. So these are a few different categories or different type of people mentioned in Quran who can be helped with zakat, what you take out of from your wealth, obligatory charity. Apart from this, you're not allowed to spend your zakat money anywhere else. But if you see somewhere, money is being used for some other purpose, and if they are doing, there might be some reason. So you should get clarification from ulama. And again, as we discussed in an earlier episode, it's always whenever you want to, if you have any doubts or anything in your mind which is not clear, it's always good to speak to ulama and get proper guidelines. Likewise, inshallah al-azim, another sadaqah wajiba is sadaqah fitr, what we give. It can be given before Eid as well, but mainly is given on the Eid al-Fitr. So normally it's the calculation of that sadaqah fitr is based on wheat, either dates or either sultanas, kishmish, okay. But our ulama, they have made it easier for us. They give us amount which needs to be taken out as sadaqah fitr. So even that is wajib on sahibe nisab. So make sure that you pay this sadaqah fitr before you go for Eid Salah, because it's said that the fast hangs between the sky and earth if sadaqah fitr is not paid. So there are people who are normally people, they try to pay it on the day, but if you know someone who is in need, and again same people who are eligible to take zakat, the sadaqah fitr can be given to same type of people. So rather than giving it on the day of Eid, and if you know someone who is in need, you can help them beforehand so that even they can celebrate Eid the way other people they celebrate. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq to get better understanding of deen, to learn more about Islam and more about the rulings which are there in Islam. And if there were any mistakes during this dars, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our ibadat, especially in the month of Ramadan, whether it is Taraweeh, whether it is our namaz, whether it is our tilawah, sadaqat, zakat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us maqam in Jannatul Firdaus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free us from the fire of hell. Inshallah al-Azim, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you all and me, everyone safe and his protection. Wa ma'alayna illa al-balagh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
आज ही SDI चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें, बेल आइकन पर क्लिक करें, हमारी हौसला अफजाई के लिए कमेंट्स, लाइक और शेयर भी करते रहें।